A fascinating link between the number of nearby exploding stars, known as supernovae, and life on Earth has been discovered. Evidence suggests a connection between changes in supernova occurrence and the fraction of organic stuff buried in sediments. This correlation can be seen over the last 3.5 billion years, and it can be seen in more detail over the previous 500 million years. The correlation suggests that supernovae have created the necessary conditions for life on Earth to exist. An explanation for the observed link between supernovae and life is that supernovae influence Earth's climate. How does it do that? A high number of supernovae result in a cold climate on Earth, with a significant temperature difference between the equator and the poles. That, in turn, leads to strong winds and ocean mixing, which are vital for delivering nutrients to ecosystems. High concentrations of nutrients result in more bioproductivity and more organic matter buried in sediments. Warmer climates have weaker winds and less mixing of the ocean, a reduced supply of nutrients, poorer bioproductivity, and less burial of organic matter. An interesting consequence is that the process of moving organic matter to sediments indirectly produces oxygen, which is the cornerstone of all complex life on Earth. Photosynthesis produces oxygen and sugar from light, water, and carbon dioxide. But if organic matter is not moved into sediments, oxygen and organic matter become carbon dioxide and water. This reverse reaction is prevented by burying organic material. As a result, supernovae indirectly influence oxygen generation, and oxygen is the basis of all complex life. Over the last 500 million years, a measure of the concentration of nutrients in the ocean reasonably correlates with supernovae frequency fluctuations. Measurements of trace elements in pyrite, which is iron sulfide, popularly known as fool's gold, buried in black shale, which is sedimented on the seabed, are used to determine the concentration of nutrients in the oceans. Measuring carbon-13 relative to carbon-12 can be used to estimate the fraction of organic material in sediments. Because life prefers the lighter carbon-12 atom, the ratio between carbon-12 and carbon-13 measured in marine sediments fluctuates due to the amount of biomass in the world's oceans. The new evidence points to a unique link between life on Earth and supernovae, which is mediated by the effect of cosmic rays on clouds and climate. According to previous studies conducted by Svensmark and colleagues, ions aid in the production and growth of aerosols, thus influencing cloud fraction. The cosmic ray-cloud relationship is vital for climate because clouds can regulate the amount of solar energy reaching the Earth's surface. Empirical evidence demonstrates that the climate on Earth changes when the strength of cosmic rays changes. Supernovae frequency can fluctuate by hundreds of percent on geological timescales, leading to significant climate changes. During the explosion of heavy stars, they emit cosmic rays that are made of elementary particles with immense energies. Cosmic rays travel to our solar system, and some of them end their journey by colliding with Earth's atmosphere. Here, they are in charge of ionizing the atmosphere. Also, a previous study suggests a faraway supernova explosion could have contributed to a minor mass extinction here on Earth 2.59 million years ago. Cosmic rays that were blasted out by the supernova may have played a role in the climatic changes that apparently led to a die-off at the end of the Pliocene epoch and the start of the Pleistocene. Africa dried out, and a lot of the forest turned into savanna. Around this time and afterward, the Earth started experiencing glaciations over and over again, and it's not clear why that started to happen. It's controversial, but maybe cosmic rays from the supernova had something to do with it. The Pliocene-Pleistocene extinction was a pretty minor one as far as these events go. Previous studies have suggested that a supernova would have to be quite close to Earth, within 25 light years or so, to trigger a major mass extinction, such as the one 65 million years ago that marked the end of the age of dinosaurs. If you like this video, please consider subscribing and click the notification bell so you do not miss any upcoming videos.